Well, you know what? Google is a funny place. And what's even funnier is the kind of things people look on it. Like, what's a boyfriend and where can I download one? To how come when I talk to girls on Facebook, they don't reply me back? From is it healthy to drink your own urine? To Anveshi, Jain. Yes. I was equally surprised when I got to know that I am the most Googled woman in India 2019. I was shocked beyond words. But to say it was a blessing is an understatement. So guys, this is the journey I'm going to take you on. It's going to be about how and why I became the most Googled. And if I have to put it in simple words, I would rather say that it's a story of a caterpillar that turned into a butterfly. We all know, right? We all know that a caterpillar will turn into a butterfly. But how many of us actually believe that? Only a few. We spend our life believing that we are only caterpillar, we are not good enough. And by the time I'm done talking, I'll leave you with the thought that if I can do it, so can you. Don't worry, to support my statement, I have visuals for you. Sorry, I didn't realize. Okay, so here, this one is an old picture, and I remember putting up a confident front. My self-esteem was touching the ground. I had major self-worth issues. And there are certain traits that tells you that you have self-worth issues, and they pretty much looks like these. So just see for yourself if you connect with this one, okay? Number one, inconsistency. People who suffer with low self-esteem feels that they are inconsistent with their jobs, with their relationship, with their promises. It is very hard for them to stick to either one person or to one job. They always keep hopping from one person to another. Number two, there are two kinds of people. One, who want to climb up the mountain so that they can see the view from the top, the beauty, the view from there. And the second one are the ones who want to climb the mountain so the others can see them. Now that I'm honest with myself, I belonged to the latter. I wanted my mom and dad to see me and feel proud of me. It was not for myself, it was for them. I'm just being honest. Number three that I felt very, very, very strongly, and I'm sure beautiful girls sitting out there, they also must be feeling this, that I am not good enough, right? Now this feeling, we don't really realize that why we act a certain way, because this happens on a subconscious level. On one hand, I was making all these beautiful vision boards, writing diaries, manifesting things, and on the other, I was not believing it. So it's like, you know, when you prepare for your interview, you give it and you really want that job badly, and when you audition for a role and you really want it, but deep down inside, you know that you're not worthy of it. Something in you tells you that you don't deserve this. It may not happen for you. That conflict, that war with yourself looks like, it is a classic example of self-worth issues. Last one. Shy to take any kind of favors, be it monetary or any kind of help. Now, these kind of people are very careful of not asking what they want. I was very terrified of asking my dad because I was doing a business for 2 years and I needed funds. And I couldn't tell him. I wanted him to understand on his own that I needed funding, dad, give me some money, but I couldn't. I met many investors at that point of time, but I couldn't showcase the investing plan very clearly because I thought I wasn't worthy of it. Why would somebody give me funding? Result, my business was shut and I was broke. Well, you know, looking at me, you must be thinking that I look so pretty on my Instagram, so many followers, right? How come a person like me will have such issues? I know it's surprising, but which is why I want you to know the real truth, my untold truth. I'm not sure if it is the right thing to do. My parents were supposed to be here, but because it is my reality, I gotta share with you because nobody else should go through something like that. I was physically abused when I was even too young to understand what it meant. I was 6 years of age. I looked like this. I felt a hand crawling inside my top. And I tried to shrink my body and I wanted to be in the corner. But that didn't help. You know, in my drawing hall, there were like maroon sofa, and you know, from the window, there used to be sunlight falling on the sofa, and I used to chase that light so that it can fall on my face, and it made my eyes look brighter and brighter. And then I also remember not chasing that light anymore, because someone was busy chasing the body of a six-year-old until she turned 7, 8, 9, and then 10. I was in 10th standard when this, I don't remember if it actually stopped, but I grew up. As you see, I grew up physically and I grew up emotionally as well. By now I was mature enough to know that this is wrong. This is a kind of abuse. This is not right. But I was not courageous enough, because you know what? Maturity and courage, they don't share the same room. I was mature enough to know that this is wrong, but I couldn't tell my parents about it. I felt resentful. I felt shameful. Well, I was now in class 10th when another tutor happened. He was a gentleman. I'm telling you, he really was. He was decent enough to ask me, Anveshi, you didn't get the sum right. How do I punish you? Tell me. Where should I touch you? Shall I touch you here? Shall I touch you here? Or shall I touch you here? While he was saying, he put his hand on my lap. By now, I should have stood up and slapped him, or at least complained about him. But guess what? Cheers to my low self-esteem that I blamed myself and I said nothing. Nobody is aware about that. I wish I could have told my parents that, Dad, Mom, I don't want to take classes from your relative. He's not teaching me good lessons. Instead, he's making me a dysfunctional human being. And you know why he was teaching me? Because he was financially poor, so my mom and dad wanted to help him. You know what? Learn to say no. Learn to say no before it hurts you on a deeper level. Learn to say no to abusive, materialistic, or forceful relationship. Learn to say no to everything that does not sit well with your ethos or with your integrity. And also, forgive. Forgive yourself for the mistakes that you haven't committed and for the ones that you did. I have forgiven myself, because if I would have known better, I would have done better. And I have also forgiven those vultures who did it to me. Not for them, but for myself. Because I cannot tell you the power of forgiving your ex-lover who ditched you, or forgiving your best friend who couldn't be with you, because it liberates you in a way that you cannot imagine. I hope that you'll do that, because I know a lot of you might have suffered from the same thing, because physical abuse is one of the most common things that happens to a lot of us, but we choose to not say or talk about this. Okay, here we go. Now, moving ahead, I want to talk about how you get what you want in life. So, you know, as a child, I was a very rebellious kid. So, and I feel that rebellious kids are really very hard to manage. At least I was. I got beaten up a lot. So one day, because I was getting bored or mujhe kuch tufani karna tha, so I threw a knife towards my brother. And it hit him. I can do that sometimes. And it hit him hard. One drop of his blood was all it took for me to run around the house 3 times. And imagine the scenario, right? Dad is chasing me to beat me, and Mom is chasing him to stop him. And my brother's enjoying the scenario. He's like out of the pain and he's laughing out loud. Hona kya tha? I got caught, I got punished, logged for 2 hours. And in those 2 hours, my delusive mind thought that, okay, it was not my fault. My mom and dad, they don't love me, and I want them to love me. So I was like very, very sad. And around that time, one uncle visited my house. And he saw that this is a sad, poor girl. So he called me close to him and he said, you know what? Look at the sky. Do you see the brightest sky, brightest star in the sky? I said, yes, I do. You know, that star is called Venus. Make 3 wishes and it will come true. And I was so excited and I was really ready to wish. Imagine someone like me, what would I wish for? Any guesses? I asked for cancer. I asked for cancer because I wanted to bask in all the attention and love from my parents. I felt very ignored in my childhood, so I wanted them to love me till I was there. But hear me out, I have 2 more wishes to go by. Second, I asked that I wanted to be an actress where I can dance around in the paddy fields, green grass, yellow flowers with my hero on a song similar to Satya. And third, I asked for pizza and to wear denims. Because I come from a small town, I always wore salwar suits with dupatta down so that nobody can see how you look. I was that. So guess what happened? In year 2012, I felt a big lump on the right side of my breast. As ignorant as I am as a human being, as convenient thinker that I am, I ignored the lump until it was too prominent to get ignored. I rushed to my hometown to see my doctor. Turns out I have multiple fibroadenoma, which means I have a tendency to develop lumps on both sides of my breast. It is a very common disease among women, but it's incurable. And you guys think it's fake. So I have to go to cancer hospital every 6 months to check whether I have cancer cells in my body, because I have fair chance to get cancer. This is how you get what you wish for. I mean, it's been 7-8 years that I've been consistently going to cancer hospitals alone, sometimes with my family members, sometimes with my friends, and I have seen people dying over there. And it scares you to death, and it's a constant reminder that you get what you wish for. That's why you need to be very, very, very careful with your thoughts and what you write and what you talk about, because the universe is always, always listening. And because it was listening, guess what happened? My other 2 wishes, they also came true. I danced with my hero in my upcoming film, and I get to wear some really nice denims, and I get to eat pizza as well. So this is how you get what you want, so be very careful, guys. I don't understand how come it is working. Okay. So yeah, the last line, I would summarize it that universe has the tendency, has the uncanny ability to latch onto every word spoken. आप आपस में भी जो बातें करते हैं अपने दोस्तों से कि यार ये काम नहीं हो रहा, मुझे ये नहीं मिल रहा, यार ये मैं नहीं कर पाऊंगी, ट्रस्ट मी, यू विल गेट. आई एम अ लाइव एग्जांपल ऑफ दैट. मूविंग ऑन टू नाउ, सम टाइम पास बाय, आई वॉज नाउ इन इंदौर, फिनिश्ड माई इंजीनियरिंग, अंडरवेंट 2 सर्जरीज, वन वॉज फॉर दिस वन, एंड देन आई वॉज मेकिंग सम गुड मनी बिकॉज नाउ आई वॉज होस्टिंग इवेंट्स. इट्स बीन 6 ईयर्स दैट माई लाइफ वॉज सेट. Until 14th of February 2014. I remember I was in an event looking beautiful in a red dress, and I was hosting a sangeet. I realized that I missed 22 missed calls from my roommate, from my flatmate. And I picked her 23rd call and she said, hello. I picked up the call and she took a deep breath. And she said, thank God you're alive. And I was in shock. She said, Anveshi, your house has caught fire. You know, I have had my moments of melancholy, but this hit me really very hard, because I lost my pet, Myra. She was only 6 months old. And then for two days, I called every friend I knew, because I wanted a space to stay, and I did not have money to afford a hotel. So I called everybody, but nobody turned up. They had bigger emergencies than mine. Why? Because I was making the news, obviously not in a good manner, but I was in the news. And then I decided to go to the ATM wearing that beautiful red dress that I was in, and And in order to take out 3,000 rupees from the ATM, you need to have 3,000 rupees in it. I only had 1,850. I took that money out. I went back home to the burnt house with the help of a helper. I asked him to click a picture. And I told him that, please click a picture. And I smiled and I said to myself that I will never be this broke again. At this moment, I was broke and broken. This is how I looked, so happy and cheerful. And this is how Myra looked. And also, the wonderful thing about this journey was that my mom and dad were not aware that all this has happened with me, because they were living in my hometown, Khajuraho. And I told one of my friends that, you know what, my mom and dad should not know that this has happened, because otherwise they will be extremely hurt and my journey, my dreams would end right here. The first thing I know that they got a phone call that aapki beti ke saath aisa ho gaya. And then the next day, I hear my mom howling over the phone and dad shouting in the background. I realized someone has sent them a 3-page long letter saying that your daughter is not worthy to leave alone like that. Please get her married. The first thing, the first guy you find, get her married, because she's not in the right job, she's not doing the right thing, she's not doing anything that will make you proud. Turns out, the same guy that I told that my mom and dad should not know about this was the one who was doing it. Why? Because he fell in love with me. And when he did not feel reciprocated from me, he decided to take it all away. And that's when everything started to make sense. You know, he used to tell me, see if you can connect with this, okay? He used to tell me that, you know what, Anveshi, you're not good with your money management. You're very bad at this. So why don't you give me your money? I'll save it for you. Bank gives 9% interest, rate of interest. I will give you 11%. So give me all your money and whenever you need it, I'm there for you. I said, okay. And the very day of the incident, when I was looking like this, he asked me for 80,000 rupees. And we were not even in good terms because I was very uncomfortable in his presence lately. So I was like, we are not even talking nicely. Why do you want that money from me? He said, okay, you don't want to give me? Fine. And he just went off. I felt bad. I put in an envelope saying, I'm sorry I hurt you, with 80,000 rupees in it, and I left the house. And that was the last time I saw my house. But you know what? When I went back, I did not find any trace either of the envelope or the money or the gold that my mom gave me. Everything was either burned into ashes or just gone. So all I could find was the smell of vengeance and revenge. All right, so you know, I think life has a wonderful way of showing that how it balances it out, you know. On one hand, I was taking away everything. And on the other, I met some wonderful people who replenished and who made me believe again in humanity and in love. My acting coach told his wife that this has happened with Anveshi. She readily agreed to keep me, because by then I already decided that Indore is done for me and I'm not going to live in this city. I moved to Bombay and I stayed with them for 3 months. And I remember that one BHK small house wherein her two grown-up kids were there, and I used to remember sleeping in a aluminium box and they were sleeping in the ground. For 3 to 4 months, they took a real good care of me. But Mumbai was a new chapter. Mumbai is altogether a new journey. We all know like how Bombay truly is. So the moment I went to the Bombay with I bought a bus ticket with that 800 bucks that I got out of the ATM, I only was left with 1,000 rupees when I moved to Bombay. And when Bombay happened, I used to do these things, like 3 audits a day, goal settings, gratitude journal, going out and eating junk. And I thought that I'm doing enough. Mujhe lagta tha ki this is the best I can do. And a lot of us have this false gratification, false sense of entitlement, wherein we feel little less and we feel like you're doing so much. I want to tell you guys, just because you're doing a lot more does not mean that you're getting a lot more done. Be self-aware. Know where you are. Do not confuse motion with progress. The two are very, very different. Very different. And then, because I was doing these things, 6 months went by, nothing happened. I was 6 kgs more weighted. Look at me, I looked like this. I was more stressed. I was rejected over 720 auditions by now already. And because you're rejected so many times, you get depression, you get depressed, and you get anxious because you're losing time. And the wonderful thing was, when I auditioned during that time, I auditioned for Mami Poco Pants ad, and I couldn't even get through that ad as well. So that was really, really a tough time for me. And then I realized there was something I was missing. And I gave a term for it for you guys. It's called self-parenting. You know, when you're not around your parents, when there is no one else to look after you and look on you, you need to watch over yourself. You need to watch your actions and be aware of what consequences are you signing up for. I started watching over my diet. I stopped going out. I started putting some real hard work, and I started watching TED Talks. I haven't left a single TED Talk till today. I also started learning about human behavior, psychology, and lie detection, because you know I was making career out of deception, right? So, again, and after all of this, while this was happening, I was again dating a guy. I was in love until I realized that he was cheating on me. And here I was, landed at my favorite place, hospital, because I was not sharing it with anybody. There was this nice doctor. She came to me, she held my hand, and she said, "Anveshi, you are clinically depressed." And then she handed me over a prescription that said, "Name Anveshi Jain, age 24, Prozac." I remember my heart was sinking, and so were my eyes. With tearful eyes, I asked her, "Doctor, can I do something before taking this prescription?" She said, "Yes, see me after a month." I came back determined that I will not let this happen to me. And I did three things. This may be of your help, please listen carefully. Number one, I put affirmations everywhere around my house, everywhere. I kept saying to myself that, "Anveshi, you are an unrepeatable miracle. You are beautiful. You are worthy of true love and affection." And then I looked in the mirror and said, "Anveshi, I make three promises to you. Anveshi, I'm proud of you. I forgive you for the mistakes that you haven't even done, or for the ones that you have done. If you would have known better, you would have done better." And the third commitment was the most important one. That, "Anveshi, I commit to you that I will make you the person that you know that you can be." And then what? I never went to that doctor again. I was healing. I was better, and to heal more. Thank you. I realized that I need to help people who are suffering from heartbreaks. So I started video blogging about heartbreaks, relationships, dating tips. And it was when, by the way, this was later. I am just, so I started blogging about this until a Facebook page who had an audience of 29 million approached me to feature my blogs there. And I was very happy to do that, because now I was touching so many lives. Although I was not making money, but coaching 2,500 people personally and 29 million people online was so gratifying that I healed absolutely completely. Thank you. And then one day, I met a gentleman in a conference. He was such a well-spoken guy that I wanted to meet him, and I realized that this guy can actually help me, because I was looking for a mentor. One thing that I have learned in life is that you need a mentor. That's very, very important. So I went up to him and I said, "Oh, I want to be successful." So he said, he was not so gentle with me, by the way. So he said, "Anveshi, why do you think that you can be successful? What makes you think that you will be successful and you will belong to the people who are in the category of 0.00001%. I was very uncomfortable hearing that question, but maybe casually I said, "Because I'm pretty and I'm hardworking." To which he said, no, you're not, you're chubby. And then I said, but I want it so bad. Then he said, but you don't work so bad for it. I was tearful by now. I said, I would do anything to be successful. Next thing I know is that I was put on a 90 days transformation, and this is what happened after 90 days. This is how I looked. And within 10 days of this transformation, I got a call from Balaji. I heard on the phone that Anveshi was selected. I jumped out of excitement that, yay, finally I'm selected, I'm gonna be an actress. And then I was called in the production house to meet a senior lady. She made me sit comfortably and she said, Anveshi, do you realize that this is a bold series? I said, no ma'am. Do you know about this series? I said, no ma'am. Go home and watch the series, first season, and then come back. If you decide to do it, we would be happy to have you. I went home and I saw, and I was feeling pity on myself. And see, I was very, very sad that this is what I'm signing up for. But you know what? By now, 1,035 days had passed without a single job. I needed work and I wanted to make it. So I chose to go with it. Despite of being aware of the repercussion and consequences, I chose to go for it because there is a thing about life. You gotta take chances. I took my chance, I did it, and the next thing I thought was that it's okay to do this show because nobody will even know about it. So I told my directors not to put my name on the credits because I don't want people to know that this is what I'm doing. But as soon as the show got out, I was Googled 29 million times and I got stereotyped. I have said no to 25 shows already because I was considered in the same kind of roles. I hope that changes eventually. So now that you think that I'm successful, I must be enjoying, I must be relaxing, chilling, going out. But my agenda, my success is not about drinking, partying, or chilling with friends. It's about putting in double efforts to whatever I do. Do you ever feel that you are in a box? Have you ever felt that? That you are trapped in dogmas of the society wherein they can tell you that you can either be this or that, never all. Well, I know how that feels. I wanted to be a singer. One day I was hosting a show for Asha Bhosle ji, wherein a gentleman who was a professional musician, he told me that, Anveshi, you have a very good voice, why don't you try singing? Then next day I hired a trainer and I started training myself. So my life right now pretty much looks like this. I get up at 7 a.m. I do meditation. That's something I would say for you too. 7:40 I do my riyaz. 9 o'clock I go to gym. 11 to 7 I finish my app work, meetings and auditions. 9 p.m. I write my gratitude diary. 10 p.m. I try and read 10 pages. And 12 to 1 I just chill. And 1 a.m. I sleep. And as far as Instagramming is concerned, that happens when I'm driving, traveling. What I want to tell you out of this is that your life is made of small decisions that you take. Small decision. It's never a big one. I took a small decision to jump out of the box. A small decision to make the best of this day that I have, because this time I'm never going to get back again. A small decision to raise my integrity bar when people wanted me to settle down. A small decision to stay away from a toxic relationship. You know what? I was criticized. I was criticized for the character I played. Okay, I was also once broke and broken. But you know what? From that very character, I became the most Googled woman and took the internet by the storm. I was once broke, but now I have multiple passive income revenues. And also, because when I started my journey, I was introduced by Shilpa Shetty for one of my shows. And right now, within a span of a year, I'm having a revenue sharing app business with her. So that's what my journey was about. So guys, if you want to take anything from my journey, I want you to take my courage and do it. Because you know what? It's possible. Your dreams can come true. If it can happen for me, surely it can happen for you. And I'm proud of you. Be proud of yourself as well. Thank you very, very much.